They say nothing is more inspiring than a challenge. And our creative agencies today have literally proved that right with the wonderful campaigns that they have dished out. We have with us in our Beating All Odds segment today, one such creative advertising leader, Srija Chatterjee, MD. Hi, Srija. MD of Publicis Worldwide. Srija, tell us, how has this lockdown affected the creative ideation at Publicis?
Well, it's actually opened our eyes that we could ideate potentially on a screen like this. Earlier, ideation was all about sitting around a sofa or, you know, going out for a smoke break and discussing ideas. Now it's a far more formal process, and initially there was some sort of tension amongst our creative people ke ye ho sakega ke nahi, but I must say it's happening very well, very efficiently actually.
Are you saying that your team is surprising you? Because, you know, there was, like you mentioned, there was a belief that unless you're bouncing off ideas with each other sitting in the same room, you can't really deliver. Is that happening in a way that surprised you right now?
Absolutely, absolutely. And nowadays what's happening is, what has happened is the regular phone call has stopped. It's all video call. So anything that you require, you're just, you know, calling the person up on Microsoft Teams, which is the platform that we're using quite well. And everything is therefore just immediately discussed and closed. And it's happening very seamlessly. I must say, I am surprised. I expected some sort of pushback or some sort of, you know, yelling ho raha hai, you know, because of this condition, this is the reason why this was not delivered. That's not happening. They're all delivering it very, very well.
But tell me, Eve, having said that, what kind of problems are you currently troubleshooting?
Well, actually, troubleshooting is about delivering. So we cannot shoot a film. So it is about looking, trying to find a solution within the, you know, allowable means, which is either looking at stock photography, looking at animation, looking at, you know, AV kind of films. So that's the only real constraint that we are in. And I guess creative works better with constraints. So they are also finding creative ways of finding the solutions. Other than that, I don't think there is any real issue. The only potential thing is that there are some employees, from an employee perspective, there are some employees who are, you know, living alone. And you know, living in this time, cooped up in your house, can be quite harrowing when you're living alone. So that's the only thing. We're just taking care that, you know, we are taking care of those employees. There are conversations happening with them regularly. We're also instituting in our organization a mental health number. So if anybody has, you know, any issues with mental health, because, you know, these things can affect different people in different ways. You know, there is a number that they can call and they can, you know, sort of get some sort of counseling and that.
You know, but unlike the other agencies, we're not really seeing a lot of these work from home ads coming from Publicis Worldwide yet. Is there a reason?
A lot of work has already come out. We handle a lot of pharma clients. A lot of pharma work has come out. We handle some B2B clients. A lot of work of those have come out.
Videos, video campaigns.
Print, video. Yes, it's a combination. A lot of work has already come out. We are not going out there and doing PR of that. Now the teams are, you know, workshopping and working with the clients regularly to plan when it opens up, what will happen in the short term, what will potentially happen in the long term, and looking at different scenario buildings and plans for that. So they are like up to here with work. So much so that nowadays, you know, this nobody's keeping track of lunchtime and breaks. And, you know, there was a whole conversation we had on that, and we said that, okay, let's just, you know, make sure that people get that half an hour, 45 minutes to eat at least, because it's just a factory.
Mm-hmm. But, you know, the lockdown has literally thrown up a different kind of challenge at the brands mostly. So as an agency, have you adapted, or are you also giving them different kinds of solutions, which is not exactly an ad? What kind of other things are you coming up with as an agency?
Actually, it depends on what the brand is, what the cycle it is in, and its developmental phase. There are different solutions that are happening. For example, a brand like ZTV. Which is, you know, a GC, and it is connected with the consumer every day. The consumer meets those characters every day. And now suddenly the consumer is not connected with those characters because obviously they are unable to shoot. How do you keep those characters alive in the minds of the consumers? Because the consumers love those characters. The viewers of those shows love those characters. So we are giving them interesting ideas, and mainly digital, because that's the medium where, you know, you can best connect at this time. And people are also now a lot more digitally active than they were earlier, even the older generation. So there are those kind of ideas that we're looking at. So how do you keep the brand alive in the minds of the consumer without super hard selling, because this is not the time for super hard selling, but yet in a softer way, yet in a kind of brand love way, stay alive in the mind of the consumer?
Well, another interesting thing is that some of the ad professionals have told me is, you know, during the lockdown, they've seen a very different kind of different side to their clients. They are much more understanding. So would you say that the clients that you have right now are less of dictators than what they were a month ago?
I mean, we don't have too many dictator clients, but whatever little we had, yeah, they're not there. I mean, they clearly, everybody understands that everybody has pressures at home. So they do understand it's work from home and work for home. And therefore, there needs to be that balance. There are SMSs coming, or rather WhatsApp coming, saying, can we connect at so and so time versus picking up the phone? So yeah, clients also need to do their share at home. So they also want that so-called me time to complete that. So they were good, they're better.
But tell me, what are the unique problems that you are hearing from clients? Anything specific that is would be nice to, you know, talk about here?
I think there is no unique. Each category is going through its own share. In fact, we had a very interesting round table that we did. So our B2B business does a lot of, not just B2B, but a lot of talent communication. So okay. Organizations connect with their consumers, with their employees, and therefore they need to communicate to them. So we do comms on that. So we had an HR round table where we called in the HR heads of a few of our clients. And it was a very interesting, talk like this, like you and I are having. So just imagine there are some 8-9 clients and there's somebody moderating it. It was a very interesting conversation on how the HR people are coping with the employee issues, also with how they are personally, developing themselves in a way, because different people are going through different learning curves. So those kind of things were very interesting. So I found that we're doing more of these roundtables now across categories. So we have a pharma one planned for tomorrow. So these are ways we are being connected with the consumer, our consumer being the clients, understanding what they're going through. And then we're workshopping with each and every client to figure out what should we be doing in the immediate, what should we be doing in the midterm, and then also laying some stones for the long term, though how long is the long term, we don't know, because that really depends on how this all pans out.
But tell me, are pitches happening right now or are they on hold?
No, very much. We had a 4-hour pitch on Friday, which was, 20 people on Zoom. It was on Zoom. We had a fantastic pitch. We have one on Saturday coming up. See, now what's happened is, because we're all working from home, Saturdays are also okay to have meetings because it doesn't matter. So we have another pitch on Saturday. So pitches are very, very much happening. And quite...
Okay. But would you say, clients, apart from, slashing ad spends, are they also looking at cutting agency costs right now?
Yes. Some clients are. Some clients are asking us for help, for partnership during these tough times. Some clients aren't. And wherever we can help, we are helping. And they also understand that we have a business to run. So they are not being, unfair. We also understand that they have a business to run. So it's each client is a different conversation. But there are some clients where we've offered to help out, where we know that those categories are going to be far more long-term affected than some of them.
But would you say in such testing times, an agency becomes that much more important for the client?
Of course, it definitely becomes far more important, because what's going to happen is you need to do communication now, which is more, as I said, you need to get the pitch right and it's going to be hard sell. But then when things come back, everybody's going to be shouting. So how do you shout best? Because once the market opens up, everybody's going to say, me. So how do you shout best? And that's when they need the partnership of the agency. They need the partnership of the agency to develop different scenarios and create plans for each scenario. And depending on what scenario pans out, because as I said, it's uncertain, then we deploy one of those plans. So definitely they need the partnership. But the reality is, you know, that that some of the businesses are under pressure, and wherever we can help, we are.
Yeah. Another thing is, you mentioned, you know, it's uncertain, and you know, once the lockdown gets, it's called off, how will the client react? So do you think the client will become more cautious because a lot of sectors production has been halted and they'll just resume? Or would you say that, you know, clients, because they haven't got much of an airtime right now, they would go out and, you know, totally spend on advertising?
My view, in the short term, the clients are going to take existing assets. They will spend, not that much, but they will, by the time they get their supply chain and the stuff into the outlets done, distribution, forgetting the word distribution. By the time they get the distribution in place, the supply chain and distribution in place, they will probably take their existing assets and they will redeploy those existing assets by making them, you know, a little bit newer here and there, which is what our task should be. And then we will start preparing, and I think the big bang will happen around August, September. You know, Ganpati time is when hopefully things will then all be back to normal to some extent, and the clients will spend on new communication, new strategies, etc.
Okay. And I was just reading, after an early release of your first quarter earnings, I mean your CEO, Chairman Arthur, he spoke about a cost-cutting plan where every country could decide how to go about it. So as far as India is concerned, are you looking at layoffs or major salary cuts for your employees?
No. As of now, we are not looking at a mass layoff or any salary cut. That we are going to really not do as much as we can. Currently, we are re-looking at, of course, you know, this is the increment cycle. So we put a hold to that for some time till we get an act as to how it's all going to pan out. We're also, you know, making sure that we don't take any third party help, and we do a lot of in-housing because we have a lot of things in our Power One solution. We have content, we have digital, we have PR, we've got everything. So mandate is you cannot go out to any other third party, work with them, because the more you go out to a third party, you're eating into somebody else's job within businesses. So everything needs to be in-house. And a few replacements that we are not replacing them for now. It's all on hold so that once we get our act together, have a better visibility as to how things are happening, then things will get opened up. So that's our kind of cost cutting.
Okay, and last question, what are your learnings from the lockdown?
Oh, my learning for the learning number one, I actually haven't stepped out of house from 19th of March. I haven't stepped out. I haven't even gone down for a walk. I'm exercising indoors. So the fact that I can be indoors for some 33 odd days and it's not going to bite me is one personal learning. I didn't know I was capable of that. I think from a professional perspective, it's amazing how humans can, you know, take over any challenge and fight that. And that's something that has been demonstrated. I mean, we know, we keep saying Mumbai is resilient and Mumbai is this and Mumbai is that, but that's really the human side to everything. All human beings are resilient. They'll find a way to break out of any issues and find a solution. The fact that the teams are working so well in such a planned manner, there are jobless meetings every morning, there's a review of the jobs every evening. Creative people are, you know, doing this so well. Of course, planning and account management really do already. And the fact that is something that, you know, has been, you know, hats off to everybody. They have understood the situation. They are doing way more than what they should. And they also know the situation that everybody is in now, and therefore they're delivering a lot more than they should. And that's something that is absolutely fantastic.
Like you mentioned, we are all working from homes, but we are more connected than ever virtually.
Yes.
So let's take this time to maybe recharge and come back with a bang when
yes.
the lockdown is actually lifted, maybe. So thank you so much for speaking to us, Shreeja. Lovely speaking to you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
See you. Take care.